Okay, so as I mentioned, today's class we will be covering, covering quickly this equivalent circuit and frequency limitations with all the information captured, from the textbook directly onto this material. I'll just brush up, each and every point with reference to this topic. And last 20 minutes, I'm reserving 10 minutes for attendance and another 10 minutes for your quiz. Today there is a quiz questions which is already prepared, and it will be circulated for you through the link. Be ready with the link, you should have proper internet connectivity. And once you click on the link that I am going to share with you, you will be given 8 minutes of time. Totally it contains 5 questions, quiz questions, 3 minutes for filling your details like your name, USN number, section, and 5 questions. You will have 1 minute to answer each question, and finally that should be submitted within 10 minutes. Okay, so this class will get over by 11:50, 11:40 to 11:50 we will reserve it for quiz time. Okay, so do not copy the answers and answer on your own. You can get the score immediately after submission, and any doubts related to quiz can be asked even later also, offline also. Okay, so this is what instruction from my side for today's class. And quiz will be purely on today's class only. It will not be covered, the quiz questions will not cover with reference to last class or previous class, topics. It will be purely on today's class. So if you listened very well today's topic, so that you can answer the quiz questions easily. Okay, so with that, let us commence today's class. If you have any questions related to quiz or related to previous class, you can ask before we start the class. Any doubts are there related to answering quiz question? Okay, if any doubts are there, you can also ask me at later point of time. Okay, this is an equivalent circuit and frequency limitations. You know what topic we are covering in today's class. It is JFET related. Our main module 4, this comes under module 4. Okay, under module 4, this is going to be the FET. Okay, let us say this is this topic what we are covering belongs to module 4 under the topic called as field effect transistors. Okay, under this topic we are covering equivalent circuit of JFET and the limitations of frequency. Every device will have its own limitation, but frequency limitation is one of the important parameter. All devices are limited by the frequency. The meaning of this is you cannot apply all AC frequencies to these devices. To some frequency the device will give a better performance, some frequencies the device will block. We will get to know that what frequency device blocks and what frequency device passes and gives better performance. Okay, mathematical model or equivalent circuit, you can call mathematical model as an equivalent circuit also. In electronic circuits, most of the devices have mathematical model or equivalent circuits. Equivalent circuits are designed or developed by many researchers, but we are listing out only the important equivalent circuits, which are accurate in the sense the output of this equivalent circuit should reflect actual device, should mimic actual device. Such kind of equivalent circuits are preferred. Okay, so though there are many equivalent circuits, every researcher will come out with an equivalent circuit, but the preferred one is which gives you the performance similar to the actual device. Okay, so this is an alternative circuits, they are called as equivalent circuits. Alternate circuit for a device such as BJT or JFET in our case. Okay, so this is required to understand transistor circuits. Many times we feel difficulty in understanding transistor circuits. It may be BJT or it may be the JFET. The one way to make our understanding easy is replace BJT with its equivalent circuit or equivalent model or mathematical model. So in that way you can make you can understand circuits very well. Okay, a circuit based on BJT or JFET. We have seen this in coupled diode model. So those we have discussed a coupled diode model in the previous module, but this actual circuit analysis we haven't done it. This real application you will see in analog circuits, we are going to discuss that in the next semester, analog circuits. There you will see the advantage of this coupled diode model. Wherever the BJT based circuit comes, then we will fit in place of BJT this coupled diode model, and we will analyze the transistor circuit so that our understanding becomes very easy. The most useful model is the small signal equivalent circuit model, which are mainly used in linear amplifier circuits. You take any linear amplifier circuits, in order to understand linear amplifier circuits, we prefer small signal equivalent circuit. Okay, we don't go for large signal, because in linear amplifier circuits, the input signal will be very small. The signal level will be, if you look at AC signal, it will be in microvolts or it can be in millivolts. Okay, this kind of, you know, the small signal, these are called as small signal. So this is small signal. Always these signals are going to be AC signals, which we apply as an input for the amplifiers. And to analyze these kind of amplifiers, we want to develop something called a small signal equivalent circuits here. The equivalent circuits what we are going to develop for JFET or JFET here in this particular topic will introduce frequency effects. You will come across in the equivalent circuit elements that are sensitive to the frequency. Okay, so example is capacitor and other elements also, like, you know, AC supply and other things. But resistors are insensitive to frequency. But we will see that, you know, these are the capacitive elements that are sensitive to the frequency. The various physical factors in the JFET affecting the frequency limitations will be considered in this topic. And we determine the cutoff frequency of a transistor, also called as figure of merit of a transistor. We will define what it is. Okay. Now we will look into the small signal equivalent circuit. The figure, you know, what we have shown here is the represents small signal equivalent circuit. For instance, you can look at the figure. This is the figure I am talking about. This is the cross sectional view of small signal equivalent circuit. Okay. So importance of each and every component has been shown here. First, we will take up cross section of a n channel PN JFET, which includes source and drain resistances. And substrate, as I told you, this is the foundation material, basic material, and it can be of gallium arsenide type or it can be of p type substrate. Always substrate will be opposite to the type of transistor what we prefer. For an n channel PN JFET, you can see here, for this particular type of JFET, the type of substrate will be of p plus. Similarly, if you want to for the p channel JFET, okay, this is another. For a p-channel PN JFET, the type of substrate preferred here is going to be the N plus. So this is an N plus substrate. Okay, here also this is P plus substrate. Okay, substrate is like a foundation material. On and above, if you diffuse with different materials, we can make a PN JFET. Okay, so transistor construction is similar to the house construction. Whenever, you know, we construct house, we lay foundation first. Okay, so on top of that, we build, you know, walls and other things, right? Similarly, even while building, while fabricating this devices like N channel or P channel, we lay the foundation first. Foundation for N channel should be of P plus substrate. For p channel, it should be of n type substrate. Okay, so that's a very important in device fabrication. And when you look at small signal equivalent circuit for the cross sectional view of a transistor, you will come across variety of, you know, the voltage sources and current sources. The first one is going to be the gate to source voltage, which is shown here as V G dash S dash. So this meaning is this is internal gate to source voltage. Internal AC gate to source voltage. Okay. gate source voltage. This voltage is responsible, you know, is required to control the output current, which is basically the drain current here. By varying this, you can also vary the adjust, you know, the output current. You can control the output current, drain current here. So drain current is, we denote it as IDS. So this is a control voltage. This is a voltage control device. Therefore, you vary the input AC voltage. So you control the output current here, IDS, okay, AC current here. Okay, next let us see in the equivalent circuit, small signal equivalent circuit. I will just show once again this small signal equivalent circuit for your reference. So this is a small signal equivalent circuit. So in the beginning I talked about the cross sectional view. This is the cross section of n channel JFET, and the equivalent circuit is shown here. So this is the equivalent circuit. Okay, this is an actual equivalent circuit, because next we are going to discuss ideal equivalent circuit, where we are going to eliminate few elements from this and develop construct, you know, ideal equivalent circuit. But this is an actual equivalent circuit. We have shown all the elements required, you know, to for this, you know, required for this to develop an equivalent circuit for this device. Okay, so this is an actual device. This is an equivalent circuit here. You can see the terminals also, which are in line with this actual device. So there is a gate here. You can see gate here. There is a source. There is a drain here, which are exactly similar to the actual device. And within that, you know, to understand more about this, we have developed an equivalent circuit here. So these circuits are going to be equal. Okay. So either in our circuit analysis, we can use actual device. Many times we use symbolic representation instead of using actual device like this. In analog circuits, we use a symbol like this for JFET. Okay. So these symbols between gate, drain, and the source, in order to analyze you know, circuits based on this device, now you can replace with this. So wherever there is a gate, you can replace between gate and source with all these elements, gate and source. Gate and drain, you can replace with all these elements. That means between these terminals, what you are seeing, gate, drain, and source, a substrate is not shown here. So you can replace with this equivalent circuit here. So that becomes easy for you to analyze, you know, any analog circuits. Okay. Okay, we will come back to that once again later on. Now let us see each and every. We already said about this. VG dash S dash is the internal AC gate voltage, gate to source voltage, that can control the output to drain current here. The other resistance and capacitances are RGS and CGS. RGS means it is internal gate to source resistance, and this is again junction capacitance between gate and source. So that is what it is explained here. This is the gate to source diffusion resistance. As I have shown with the symbolic representation here, this resistance is within this device, it is between gate and source. This is an RGS, okay, and there is a junction capacitance between the gate and source. So here we have a junction capacitance, which is a capacitance that exists between the gate terminal and source terminal of an actual device. Okay, the role of this is explained later on. Okay, so the gate to source junction is always reverse biased, because this device can be operated in two modes. One is depletion mode and other one is enhancement mode. JFETs can be operated in these two modes. Okay. What do we mean by depletion mode? Whenever you make VGS as negative, the mode is called, you know, the depletion mode. We have seen in the operation of, you know, the JFET, what is you know, depletion mode and enhancement mode. For all the values of, you know, VGS negative, we call it as a depletion mode. Enhancement mode means for we are keeping VGS as positive. So here for enhancement mode, always VGS will be positive. Okay, as you apply VGS, positive VGS voltage, the current will get, you know, channel will get enhanced, and henceforth the current also will get increased. But here, you know, when you go more and more negative, okay, so the depletion mode device, you know, the current, you know, it keeps varying depending on the voltage, how much voltage you apply here. So these are the two things we need to understand here. This JFET can be operated in depletion mode and as well as enhancement mode. And in the depletion mode, usually the gate to source junction is reverse biased, whereas in enhancement mode, gate to source junction is forward biased. and look at why we have taken this depletion mode and enhancement mode here, because we want to know that this value, whether it is large or small. Okay, so when we operate JFET in the depletion mode, this value will be very large. So this value RGS is going to be very large, okay, because it is reverse biased. Reverse biased, the resistance within the device, reverse biased PN junction is going to be very large. Okay, and next is going to be the other elements like RGD and CGD. Between gate and drain, the JFET exhibits resistance and as well as capacitance. That is shown as RGD. It is a resistance, gate to drain resistance between gate and drain, and gate to drain junction capacitance between the gate and drain. So these are the two elements that device exhibits between the gate and drain. And next is RDS. Okay, so RDS. Let me discuss even values also. These values RGD and CGD will be nominal. I can't say it is very large, but here you know RGS is going to be very large because it is reverse biased in the depletion mode. RDS, drain to source resistance. So drain to source resistance is nothing but resistance between the drain and source terminal. Okay, so this always combines with output resistance. Usually for a JFET, drain and source serves as an output. So therefore, this internal resistance RDS will be parallel to the output resistance. If I connect, you know, resistance RL or Rout between the drain and source, internal resistance RDS will be in parallel with output resistance RL or R0. Okay, so this value will be, you know, should be as small as possible for a linear amplifier circuit. Input resistance should be as large as possible, okay, for a linear amplifier circuit. So RDS is nothing but drain to source resistance, and RDS is basically a function of channel length modulation effect. Okay, so channel length is, again, it is a function of so channel length, we indicate this as delta L. It is going to be a function of drain to source voltage VDS, voltage applied between this. Usually we see characteristics of output characteristics of JFET, a constant with reference to VDS. Suppose if I plot output characteristics of JFET, this device, by taking drain source voltage along x axis and drain current along y axis IDS, you will get a constant curve like this. This is for different values of VGS. Say this is for VGS some volts, say 2 volts. Okay. So what this shows here is when you start varying this VDS starting from 0 up to some value, drain current increases. Beyond that, you can see that device is getting saturated. This we have seen in BJT also. Okay, so device gets saturated. This is an ideal, you know, the characteristics I have drawn here, because here ideal in the sense the slope is going to be 0 here. Slope is 0. Okay, but practically the device will exhibit characteristics something like this with finite amount of slope. Probably you, if you remember early voltage that we have discussed in JFET, this becomes, you know, easy for you to understand. If you remember that we've extended all these lines to the negative axis here, and we told this voltage as early voltage in BJT, right? Same thing here also, whenever there is a finite amount of slope, this curve has got finite amount of slope. Now here in this case, slope is not equal to 0. And now look at here, whenever there is a 0 slope, the drain current, drain to source current becomes independent of VDS. Okay, whenever there is a finite slope, now you can see as you keep increasing drain to source voltage, corresponding drain to source current keeps increasing. Okay, and now this is called, you know, the channel length modulation effect. Now this drain to source voltage, as drain to source voltage keeps increases, okay, the channel length also keeps varying. I mean the this delta L. Okay, so the channel length keeps varying, and channel length is now, it is a function of drain source voltage, because drain source resistance keeps varying, and corresponding to that, you know, the drain source voltage, the channel length also keeps varying. And all these things are, you know, explained with when the device is operated in saturation region. So this is not applicable when you operate device in the cutoff region or linear region. So we assume that when the device is operated in saturation region, So this is the characteristics plotted, shown under saturation region, because you can see whenever there is a constant current flows, this region is called saturation region. Okay. So there is a linear region also here, we should not forget it. This region is a linear region. When you analyze the BJT and FET, they are totally, you know, different. Okay, so this region in BJT we called as saturation region, but in JFET this region becomes a linear region, and here we have a saturation region. I would like to highlight here with a different color so that you can understand which is linear region and which is saturation region. You can, I will show you with the green color line here, you can see that this is actually the a graph. You can see this line is a bifurcation between linear and saturation. The small region whatever you see here, it is a linear region, because the current, the voltage VDS and the current are, they are linearly related here, whereas beyond this green color curve what you see is going to be saturation region. This region is very important when we use JFET as an amplifier. We need to operate JFET in the saturation region to be a good amplifier. Okay, cutoff is exactly which is on x axis here. So this is cutoff. Now you, by looking at various regions, you can imagine now where we can, in which region we can use JFET as a switch, and which region we can use JFET as a amplifier. JFET will work like an amplifier when you operate in a saturation region. JFET will work like an on switch when you operate in a linear region. JFET will be working like an, it works like an half switch when you operate in the cutoff region. Now you can compare these things with the BJT. It is a little different when you simultaneously study the BJT. Okay. So with that, we will move on to the other important, you know, the parameters like CDS. It is a drain to source. It is not ordinary capacitance. It is a parasitic capacitance. Just keep in mind. What do you mean by parasitic capacitance? What do you mean by parasitic capacitance? There are other, you know, elements which influence, you know, the device, you know, the other elements, other, you know, the suppose if any wire, you know, if you have an electric wire carrying a current here, adjacent wire, you know, may also carry some current. So now there is a capacitance between these two wires here. This is called, you know, the parasitic capacitance or stray capacitance here. Okay. This wire also, it is carrying current, this also it is carrying current. Between those two, it looks like a parallel plate, right? Okay, you might have seen this in transmission lines, right? When two wires are adjacent to each other, if they carry this current, between those two, there is a capacitance effect. This is called parasitic capacitance. Now, this capacitance introduced here between these two wires influences both the current flowing here, charge carriers flowing here, and as well as here. The same thing we also experience in JFET. So that is between the drain and source. So that capacitance is called parasitic capacitance. And there is a capacitance between the drain and drain to substrate also. Substrate is this, here we have a terminal, you know, fourth terminal which you can call as a substrate. This is a substrate. Okay. Here we have a capacitance. Okay. So that capacitance we are calling here as CS, drain to substrate. Not only at substrate, it is between drain and substrate, the capacitance which is here. So this is drain to substrate capacitance. Okay. So there are various capacitance existence, you know, here you are, what you are seeing. We have seen CGS, CGD, CDS, CS. There are totally four capacitances, but among these, the two are only the dominant capacitance. Okay, large value capacitance that affects frequencies. The one is going to be the CGS. This capacitance. The other one is going to be the CGD. So, except these two capacitances, the other are very small, that can be ignored. Okay. So, the ideal small signal equivalent circuit, which is shown in figure 9.18a, all diffusion resistances are infinite. Now, we see that we modify the actual equivalent circuit and develop a simplified equivalent circuit like this. You will simultaneously look at these two things. The actual equivalent circuit and the simplified equivalent circuit here. So this is a simplified equivalent circuit. Okay. So we have obtained a simplified equivalent circuit from this actual equivalent circuit, what you are seeing here. So from this actual equivalent circuit, this simplified equivalent circuit can be obtained. So this is a simplified, or let us call this as an ideal equivalent circuit. Instead of calling simplified, let us go as per the textbook notation. So this is an ideal equivalent circuit. So this is an ideal equivalent circuit. So when you want to analyze, a circuits based on JFET quickly, then you can ignore many things, redundant things here, and you can use this model what it is shown. You can observe here between the gate and source there is a open circuit. Okay, this shows that there is a large input resistance, right, between the gate and source. We talked about RGS. RGS is infinity here. Look at this. Reason is open circuit here. So between the gate and source there is a open circuit. Okay, any device that exhibit open circuit, that means its resistance is infinity. So here you can say that resistance between the gate and source RGS is going to be infinity. That is the meaning here. Okay, it's very much essential for linear amplifier circuits. Okay, for any good amplifier, its input resistance must be very, very high. Okay, so it can draw less current from the source. And look at it, its output is replaced with a dependent current source here. So that means this current source, current flowing here, depends on the voltage what we apply here. This is an AC voltage. Okay, sinusoidal signal we apply here with a different frequency. As frequency keeps changing, the output current also keeps changing. This current value is IDS. Okay, so this is equivalent to IDS. IDS is equal to GM times VGS. GM is the transconductance or gain of the JFET. So it is nothing but gain of JFET. Okay, so GM is transconductance. It's measured in ampere per volts. Higher the GM is always good for amplifiers. So VGS is an AC signal here. Any variations here will also makes the drain to source current to vary. And source is usually it is grounded. This looks like a common source or common emitter in case of BJT. Source is directly it is grounded. So if you look at this JFET now, let us say this is a JFET symbol. Okay, between the gate, drain and source, the ideal equivalent circuit looks like this. So between the gate and source there is an open circuit, between the drain and source there is a current flowing, this current is IDS. The value of this current now depends on GM times VGS. VGS is nothing but voltage applied here. So GM is the transconductance of the device. Okay, so this is the ideal equivalent circuit. Now let us see important things what we are covering here. Okay, so all diffusion resistance are infinite. In actual equivalent circuit, these things can be neglected because they are infinite. RGS, RGD, RDS, they are infinite. So in the equivalent in the actual equivalent circuit, if you make them as infinite, you will get a ideal equivalent circuit. Let me show that what all the elements we are going to neglect here. RGS becomes infinity. So this becomes redundant in the ideal equivalent circuit. RGD becomes infinity. RDS becomes infinity. When I say into mark, that must be open circuit, open circuit, open circuit here. And this RD becomes short circuit. This is zero. This becomes a short circuit. And RS also becomes short circuit. And we will ground here in the AC, in the ideal equivalent circuit. And look at other capacitances which becomes, this is what we have showed about for the resistances. All diffusion resistance are infinity, therefore that can be made open circuit. Infinity means open circuit. All series resistances are zero. We have shown that RD and RS, they are replaced with zero. Zero means short circuit. At low frequencies, let us look into the capacitances now. At low frequency, capacitor reactance will be very high, so capacitor becomes open circuit. So because at low frequency, we know the formula for capacitive reactance, Xc is equal to 1 by 2 pi Fc. This frequency is low, so let us say 0 value, this Xc becomes infinity, right? But this having low frequency AC signal frequency smaller, capacitive reactance becomes very high. So therefore, Xc is very high. So capacitors at low frequency, you can make them as open circuit. So capacitors like CGS, CGD, CDS, all this becomes open circuit. So that's what we have done in the actual equivalent circuit. So you can see this also will go off CDS. So CGS open circuit here, and this also will be, it will go off. And what you're left out is the open circuit between gate and source, that's what you are seeing here in the ideal circuit, and there's a current source between drain and source. So there's a current source. So this is an ideal equivalent circuit. So with all that assumptions, what we have shown here, if you apply to the actual equivalent circuit, you will get an ideal equivalent circuit. So ideal small signal equivalent circuit can be written based on this, okay, assumptions, approximations. Okay, for the now, if you look at the ideal equivalent circuit, the current that is flowing in the drain to source is given by this equation Gm times VGS. Okay, this we have already told with reference to ideal equivalent circuit. So Gm is called transconductance, which is in ampere per volts, and VGS is the input signal voltage. The effect of source resistance can be determined using this formula. So now we will have another circuit with and without RS. I'll show you the circuit next to this. Now, small change here we have done here. This ideal equivalent circuit does not have this RS. So, here this is a circuit without RS, without resistance between the source and the ground here. Okay. So, but if you include RS, let us see the effect on the gain. So, this is a circuit what you are seeing, same circuit with connected RS here. So, there is a RS here with RS. Now, let us see if I connect RS to this ideal small signal equivalent circuit, what is its effect on the voltage gain? Let us see that. Okay. So, considering this circuit, now you can apply KVL here in this loop what we have shown for the gate source loop. So, you can once you apply KVL, you will get the minus VGS plus V dash VG dash S dash plus IDS times RS. So, I am going like this VG dash S dash, current flowing through this is same IDS. So, this is IDS. So, which is equivalent to GM times VG dash S dash. Now, drop across this is now, drop across this. Okay. If I call this as a VS, drop across this source resistance, it is RS times GM times VG dash S dash. Okay. So, this is the equivalent. This is the KVL. Okay. After applying, you get this equation by applying KVL to gate source loop. Gate source loop. So, this is the equation you obtain. You can simplify this by taking this sending this to the right hand side, you get VG dash S dash plus ID times RS. Now, substitute for ID as IDS here, not ID, IDS here, IDS as GM times VG dash S dash. So, that is what we have done in the notes material. You can go through that. Okay, after applying KVL, you can see that you get this equation. On simplification, you get this, and but we know that IDS is equal to GM VG dash and S dash, that is from equation 2. Okay, now if you substitute here in place of IDS, you will get this equation. You can take VG dash S dash here common, and you get this term, and let us obtain equation for this internal gate to source voltage VG dash S dash is equal to VGS divided by 1 plus GM into RS. So this is the, let us call this as equation 3. Now you can substitute equation 3 in equation 2. Equation 2 is this IDS, okay, equation. So what you get is IDS is equal to GM divided by 1 plus GM into RS into VGS. And this can be written as IDS is equal to, this complete thing can be substituted with this GM dash, okay, this GM dash. So IDS now becomes GM dash into VGS, where GM dash is equal to this complete term, GM into 1 plus GM into RS. Okay. Now you can compare equation 1 with 4. What is equation 1? Look at this equation 1. IDS is equal to GM VGS. So this is a small signal equivalent circuit without RS. And now you can compare that with RS. With RS, this is the equation. Okay. So this is the equation with RS, IDS equation with RS. And this is the IDS equation without RS. Without RS. Now compare IDS equation without RS and with RS. Okay, so now we can write this with and without RS, GM are related like this. So without RS, this is just we have a GM. And the moment you add RS, okay, so you can see that transconductance GM is reduced by a factor of 1 plus GM into RS. Okay, so that means gain reduces in BJ, in JFET here. So that's what we want to say here. The source resistance reduces the effect of transconductance or transistor gain by the factor 1 plus GM into RS. Okay, that's what you can see here. The moment you connect your resistance here, RS, the gain of this JFET keeps decreases. Okay. Now here this is an alternative equivalent circuit with RS. So if you have a JFET with you, okay, this is a gate, drain and a source. Here if you have an RS, then this is the equivalent circuit you must use. If you don't have RS, then this is the ideal equivalent circuit we are supposed to use. But with RS, gain decreases. Okay, we have seen that GM becomes very less. Okay. So GM becomes GM by 1 plus GM into RS. So this is with RS. This complete thing what you are seeing on right hand side is with RS and this is without RS. Okay. Now what is the advantage of using RS now? So because gain we are saying it decreases the moment we connect RS, but if you look at the stability point of view, having RS is always good. Okay, so this is improves stability. This RS, though the gain decreases, gain the sense the GM decreases, but stability improves. What do you mean by stability? Any idea you have? Stability against variations like temperature or the any parameter of a transistor. With reference to that, you know, the other factors, you know, keeps changing. The output current keeps changing. So with reference to that, this RS provides stability. Okay, any variations in the output current that gets stabilizes because of RS. So in order to improve the stability in a amplifier circuit, we must use RS. But now you should have a trade-off whether we want to have a decreased gain or improved stability. If you don't want to use this RS, then output current, you know, varies. Okay, with parameters, temperature, you know, the gain and other things, temperature and other parameters, you know. So now it is a, there is a trade-off now here between, now you have to decide whether you want to have a smaller gain and improved stability, use RS, or if you want to have a larger gain, then this RS can be removed. So the option is left to the designers. Okay, so now let us proceed further here. We have compared, you know, GM, this is a transconductance, is now it is a function of gate source voltage, DC gate source voltage. This is this GM dash is a new saturation transconductance, that is again, it is a function of gate source voltage, DC gate source voltage. All these things comes under, when we operate JFET under the saturation region here. Okay, saturation region means already we told whenever we want to use JFET as an amplifier, we must operate in the saturation region. All these definitions are defined under saturation region. Okay, any questions so far? And I will just quickly cover this, and later on, this is a very small topic, there is no major changes here. Frequency limitation factors and cutoff frequency. There are two frequency limitation factors with reference to JFET. One is channel transit time, which we call as a tau t. Other one is capacitance charging time here. So these are the two things which affects frequency, okay, limits frequency in a JFET. Now let us see what is this channel transit time. The channel transit time definition is how much time the transistor takes to transfer charges from source to drain. Let us draw here this JFET. So this is going to be the gate, and here we have a source and a drain here. This is going to be the channel region here. This is the channel length is capital L. This is called as a transit time. How much time the it needs, okay, so for the electron or charge carriers to transfer between these two points, okay. So this is typically in picoseconds. You can see typically it's going to be 10 to 50 picoseconds, very very small amount of time it takes here. So this is called as a transit time. So channel transit time, so the time taken by the charge carriers to move from source end to the drain end, that is the definition of channel transit time. It is defined as tau t. So definition wise it is length by velocity, saturation velocity. So L by Vs, saturation velocity of the carriers, at what velocity, at what rate the charge carriers are moving. So typically the if I take channel length as 1 micrometer and velocity of saturation velocity as 10 to the power of 7 meter per second, if you substitute in this equation, so you will get the transit time as 10 picoseconds approximately. So this is a transit time for the charge carriers. Okay. Capacitance charging time, we will discuss this in the next class. Even the frequency limits, okay, this is also the frequency is JFET, within a JFET the frequency is limited by this capacitance charging time. We have seen various capacitances in the equivalent circuit, even those things also get affected by the capacitance charging time, will affect those frequencies. Okay. So we will continue this in the next class, and because it's right now it's a time for quiz, and I will stop at this point this class and continue with your quiz questions.